Welcome to Grab and Go Info. S-Learner is a meta-learner that uses a single machine learning model to estimate the individual-level causal treatment effect. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to implement S-Learner in Python, how to make individual treatment effect estimation using S-Learner, how to segment customers based on the individual treatment effect estimation. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import the Python libraries. Firstly, let's install CausalML for synthetic dataset creation. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. Pandas is imported for data processing. Synthetic data is imported for synthetic data creation. Seaborn is for visualization. LGBM regressor is for the machine learning model training. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the S-Learner Uplift model. Firstly, a random seed is set to make the synthetic dataset reproducible. Then, using the synthetic data method from the CausalML Python package, we created a dataset with 5 features, 1 treatment variable, and 1 continuous outcome variable. After that, the dataset is saved in a pandas data frame. Finally, using value counts on the treatment variable, we can see that out of 1,000 samples, 512 units received treatment and 488 did not receive treatment. In step 3, we will train an S-Learner model. S-Learner trains a single machine learning model, and that's why it's called S-Learner. The model features include covariates and the treatment variable. We created a variable called features that includes x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, and treatment. The dependent variable is the outcome variable. We created a variable called y that includes the outcome column y. The model selection and hyperparameter tuning are important for the performance of an S-Learner. This is because the model performance affects the model predictions, hence the accuracy of the individual treatment effect estimation. Many machine learning model algorithms can be used to build the S-Learner. The model algorithms include but are not limited to lasso regression, ridge regression, random forest, XGBoost, and a neural network model. A light GBM model is used in this example, and the process is the same for other machine learning model algorithms. After initiating the LGBM regressor method, we fit the model using the features and the outcome variable. In step 4, we will make predictions using an S-Learner model. To make the treatment effect estimation, 2 separate predictions need to be made using the trained model. In the first prediction, the treatment variable is set to 1 for all the samples. This gives us the predicted outcome values if all the samples receive the treatment. In the second prediction, the treatment variable is set to 0 for all the samples. This gives us the predicted outcome values if none of the samples received the treatment. In step 5, we will calculate the individual treatment effect using the S-Learner predictions. Individual treatment effect is the difference between the predicted outcomes with and without treatment. After calculating the individual treatment effect, the data is saved in a data frame. The histogram visualization of the individual treatment effect shows a normal distribution. The average treatment effect is around 0.5. Most individuals in the dataset have a positive treatment effect. Some individuals have negative treatment effects. In step 6, we will estimate the average treatment effect using the S-Learner predictions. The average treatment effect for the population is the average of the individual treatment effect. We can see that the average treatment effect is 0.47. To learn more about the definition and calculation for the average treatment effect, please check out my previous tutorial 8 vs. Kate vs. ATT vs. ATC for causal inference. In step 7, we will talk about how to segment customers using individual treatment effect from the S-Learner. An uplift model divides customers into 4 groups based on the incremental change caused by the intervention. A common use of the uplift model is for marketing campaigns. The common treatments in a marketing campaign can be emails, displays, and promotions. Persuadables are those who buy with treatment and do not buy without treatment. Loss causes are those who do not buy with or without treatment. Sure things are those who buy with or without treatment. Sleeping dogs are those who buy without treatment and do not buy with treatment. Based on the uplift model customer segmentation, we divide the individuals into 3 groups using their individual treatment effect. Sleeping dog is a segment with the individual treatment effect less than minus 0.5. These are customers who would have made the purchase if they did not receive and get annoyed by the marketing messages. Persuadable is a segment with the individual treatment effect greater than 0.5. These are customers who would have made the purchase if they received the marketing messages, but would not make the purchase if they did not receive the marketing messages. No impact is a segment with the individual treatment effect between minus 0.5 and 0.5. Because their individual treatment effects are close to zero, we consider the marketing messages do not have any impact on their purchasing decisions. This segment includes both lost causes and sure things groups. After creating the customer segments, we created a column in the data frame. The visualization of the segments shows that nearly half of the individuals are persuadable, very few individuals are sleeping dogs, and more than half of people are not impacted by marketing campaigns. These segments can help optimize the marketing strategies and increase the return on investment. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about causal inference, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.